Well, our shop is empty. Even the engine hoist is empty. Oh, but some things are even more important than jets. We resurrect all sorts of machinery here. So once again, I'm going to have to resort to another whiteboard explanation. Turbojets versus turbofans. Stay tuned. Okay, a couple more diagrams to further explain some of the more subtle differences, just to explain everything better. I've drawn on the top our typical industrial engine, which is a single spool gas generator. It's basically a turbojet engine minus the nozzle, and I've included this would be the power turbine. You've seen that in the last diagram. All of the air going in, let's see if I can reach up there, all the air going in goes through the entire engine, is combusted with the fuel, and comes out the back and through the power turbine. This is the Rolls-Royce Olympus, which has a high pressure compressor and high pressure turbine, which is hollow, and a shaft passing through it for the low pressure turbine, which drives the low pressure compressor. Now this engine would run by itself, just with the core or the high pressure system. You could think of the low pressure system as almost like a turbocharger for a jet engine. It takes some of the exhaust energy and uses it to compress the air coming in to make the whole thing more powerful and more efficient. So it is very much like a turbocharger for a turbine engine. And again, that has a power turbine. All of the air going through or going into the intake goes all the way through the engine, is burnt, and comes out. Now the CF66, which is an early airliner turbofan engine, it's also a two-shaft engine. What makes it different from a two-shaft turbojet? Well, the engine intake is actually this large in a turbofan, and some of the air going into the engine intake gets bypassed around the engine. So that's why it's called a turbofan. It could be called a bypass turbojet. I'm sure it was in the first few years of its use, but it's been known to be, or it's been become known as a turbofan engine. And it has, again, a high pressure compressor, high pressure turbine, that would run by itself, although fairly inefficiently, and a larger low pressure turbine, because the low pressure turbine doesn't just turbocharge the engine, because it still does that, it still increases the pressure of the air going through the engine, but it's got this extra enlarged first and actually second stage compressor wheel, slightly. This is a bit of a unique engine because it's got a two-stage fan. This larger area of the low pressure compressor, it takes power to push that air past the engine. The bypass airflow is very large and it contributes significantly to the thrust, but it takes a lot of power to do that. So that's why the low pressure turbine is much larger in the CF6 than in the single stage of the Rolls-Royce Olympus. There's a lot more air getting moved through here. The total airflow for the Olympus is around, I'm guessing here, I'm vaguely, fuzzily putting out numbers. It's about, let's say, 200 pounds of air per second at a very high velocity exhaust jet. The CF66 has, now this is roughly, around 1200 pounds per second. So you can see there's a much larger amount of air being shoved backwards, and the total average velocity of the exhaust is quite a bit lower, but that's good for an airliner, because as the speed of the aircraft gets closer to the speed of the exhaust gases, your efficiency rises. So a turbojet powered airliner is quite inefficient and they burn a lot of gas. Anyway, that's the difference that the fan adds to a two-shaft engine. You can get an idea of the bypass from the size of the struts and the fan casing. This is the
engine casing. All the air that's going to be burnt goes through there. And this is a strut that mounts the fan case to the rest of the engine. And all this area here is fan airflow or bypass airflow.
And now, this could be converted, and it has been by the manufacturer, to an industrial gas generator. It's right here, the diagram we saw in the previous video. It is the, oh, I didn't put a name on there. That's the LM2500, and it's got the same compressor, the same high pressure compressor, the same high pressure turbine, the same hollow shaft, but nothing passes through it. It's got this, it's actually got a larger, one stage more low pressure turbine. And in this case, because it doesn't power a flight device, the turbofan or the fan of the engine, it's called a power turbine. Low pressure turbine, it's also technically called the low pressure turbine, but it's referred to as the power turbine. And it's integral with the engine, which makes this engine different from the Avon, because the power turbine is part of the engine. Here it's an extra piece of equipment that you attach, but it's very similar. So one of the systems, the low pressure system, has been, I suppose, the forward part, the compressor part, has been removed, and the turbine's been modified so the output's at the rear. But these two here, it's a little bit confusing sometimes because they're both two shaft engines. One's a turbojet, one's a turbofan. The main difference is the first stage or two of the low pressure compressor is enlarged to have bypass airflow. That's why the Olympus is not a turbofan, it's a turboshaft, or sorry, it's a turbojet.
Let's see if we can take a look at the second stage of the fan. It's, you see it moving back in there?
So I hope these diagrams are a bit more clear and they help clear up some of the finer nuances of the differences between different types of large turbine engines.
That's a stator from the second stage of the fan, and that I'm pointing at is a blade. I can't reach in there and turn it, it's too far away. Reaching through the stators from the first stage of the fan, I can't quite reach them. But that's the second stage of the LP compressor, or in this engine, it's also known as a fan.
Okay, before I erase the diagrams completely, one last question. Why is the power turbine larger in an LM2500 than a CF6? Let's take a closer look at those. Okay, without the names on them, that's the CF6, that's the 2500. The reason is, any extra energy that's in the exhaust stream of the CF6 that is not extracted by the turbine and used by the fan to produce thrust is accelerated out a smaller nozzle and contributes to the thrust. So you've got about an 8-to-1 ratio of power going through the fan versus coming out the hot jet exhaust. So you can use this residual energy here to do something to help push the aircraft forward. With the 2500, any additional energy left over past the power turbine is simply given up. It's wasted, or it's given up to the heat recovery system. So what the power turbine wants to do in the 2500 is extract all of the energy that it can from the exhaust gases of the gas generator. That's why you've got one extra stage on this power turbine than you do on the low pressure turbine of the turbofan. Just another detail. And that's what I'm here for, to explain the minor details of the jet engine world and to try not to stutter. At SNS Turbines, once again, thanks for watching.